drive safely.
Okay, that one's working.
And starting recording.
Yep, there it goes. Righto, well, we're not going anywhere at any speed.
No.
Righto.
Dryness gets me though, because I feel like I've got to get up and whip my whistle all through the night.
Ah, okay. Yeah.
And that repeat every few hours.
Yep.
Thank you. what's that there? Grain?
Grit, I think.
Grit, yeah.
Should be on M for manual?
I don't know.
Okay, let's see, here we go.
It's not on manual, eh?
It was on effects.
Yeah.
That thing yesterday in Wells, yeah, where they're talking about the sheep.
Yeah.
One of the things that I found was that thing there said that they preferred round bales for feeding, because you can feed easier, because basically you just unwrap the thing. Yeah. You just roll it out like a tub.
Oh, no, that's what my father-in-law does.
Yeah.
So what he does is he puts it in the correct way.
Yeah.
Cuts it, ties the strings to the ute.
Yeah.
And pushes it off, and it rolls down the hill like a carpet. There's a big solar farm.
Yeah. Good stuff up here.
Yeah.
Nice and high, you get more sun.
Yeah.
And it's cold, so they work better. done to the tracking. Yeah. We've seen a lot of tracking places.
Yeah. And this looks like it's got a petrol station, maybe a cafe.
Eat.
Is it?
Well, there's a sign there that says eat.
Okay, let's go in there. Eat. Oh, yeah, come on. Should be a good
over next to the sign. Yeah. Already winds.
What's that?
Well, it's already blowing.
Yeah. Safely. Doesn't necessarily mean anything nefarious occurred. It just could be that they thought they'd tell the relatives that someone had died or something before they...
And in a place like this, you might find that there's lots of people linked into those emergency services stuff because half of them are doing it.
Yeah.
I know that there's places in Australia where half the town is in emergency services.
Yeah. All part-time employees or full-time. Yeah.
No, what I mean is they're all volunteers, but they're all...
It's like when I was up here in winter, everyone's truck had a snowplow on the front.
Yeah.
There we go.
Turn left onto US 93 North.
On my side? Yeah, you're fine.
Okay, on my side, I'm fine.
Okay.
Continue on US 93 North for 21 miles. This route avoids road closures on Idaho 33 East. You are on the fastest route. You should reach your destination by 12:30 p.m.
Drop a little bit slower than the speed limit today because there's no fire rush. It's becoming more agricultural as you go north too, isn't it? Like, growing of stuff. And...
faster up here too.
Yeah.
it's 9:30 now here.
I've got 8:22 on the clock, almost probably, 9:21.
Okay.
It's got 8:22.
Ah, but we might be in your in that time zone.
Yeah, we're in a different time zone. If the car had all its features, it'd be telling you what the time zone was. But they appear to have very limited conductivity to the system. So, you know, when I went to do Mercedes stuff, not covered under.
Yeah, well,
that'd be the big business up here.
That's one of the things that I've been looking at is feed, because I don't actually see many cattle.
No. But if they do have cattle, they might be in the higher country or something right now, and they'll bring it back down. But I could imagine lucid, like feed for cattle, would be a big business in a place where there's reasonable cattle stocks, you know, in surrounding states and stuff. And
well, in that sheep thing, they talk about that, and they talk about you've got to feed them.
Yeah.
In the winter.
Yeah.
And the advantage with the sheep is that's all you've got to do. You don't have to provide water.
No wonder Australia, thrives as a sheep herding place, because, you know, basically you can keep them outdoors and let them feel what's on.
Now you're talking about Demiloquin.
Yeah.
I'm wondering if you get a similar sort of thing here.
Oh, I guarantee you.
But from a time zone point of view, because that slurry truck,
yeah,
it was Intermountain slurry truck. So the guy we know in Salt Lake City,
yeah,
healthcare.
Oh, okay.
So what I'm wondering is it sort of a place called Intermountain? Well, sorry, an area called Intermountain.
Yeah.
And these guys are closer to that than they are. A little bit like BHP. Sorry, the Broken Hill still does.
Yeah.
Ran on South Australian time.
Changed, but...
Well, that's a good looking lump of corn. It's less good. That looks like the irrigation didn't work.
The same here on the edge, it's not doing as well.
Patient. So is that what the dam does?
Quite possibly. Because they dam the shit out of the rivers. The river or something. They're actually de-damming a lot now.
Yes, well.
And they're finding as soon as they do, things like salmon and that are fucking coming back.
Yep.
So they seem to be starting downriver and working their way back up. There'll be some that they keep, obviously, but the finding it's had an effect on...
If you don't maintain a dam for 100 years, they fall apart.
Mm.
And there was a video I saw the other day. It's fairly recent.
I'm going to pull up here and take a photo, just so it shows up as a location on my map. the name of that town?
Which one?
The one we were just in.
Where we ate?
Yeah.
Well, it was called Helen's Place.
Yeah.
I'm not sure it was a town.
Shows up as a service station, not Helen's. That'll remind me later to write a review. And when I write the review, Helen's will most probably pop up. I like reviewing little places like that that you may not stop at.
Yeah. Hollis. Somebody probably off grid.
Yeah. I can't see any wires going there. Actually, where are the power lines for you?
There's one over there on the ridge.
Okay.
Thank you.
grain sort of handling facility, isn't it?
Yeah, they're blending. They're blenders.
Yeah.
So for stock feed, but it's just what he's got in his backyard.
Houses tend to have quite big gardens.
Yeah. I have a suspicion. I'd be interested to know what it's like living in American society.
Yeah.
Because it seems to me that it has...
Australia, most farmers' wives run gardens around the house.
Oh, yeah.
like the old wooden cottage over there, nice manicured grass.
Feed mill and I raise your.
Okay.
That's
okay.
Bigger.
Some concrete in people's places. There's been a few places where it looks like they've dismantled some, like a, you know.
What colour was it?
Whitish. Yeah, okay. White grey. It looks like concrete, not rocks.
Yeah.
It's my initial thing was thinking. They're still pulling rocks out of the paddocks or something, but it looked like a disused building.
Half a mile, slight right onto Idaho 74 North.
is probably just as far enough below the that channel.
Yeah.
70 outside, is it?
Yeah. 73, yeah.
Area around it, compared to some places we've seen recently, is relatively densely populated.
Yeah.
Okay, to far side.
Yeah, far side as well. house. Like, my house is in here. That's not so nice, but...
In a quarter mile, turn left onto North 3100 East, Eastland Drive South. Take the next left onto North 3100 East, Eastland Drive South. Continue on North 3100 East for 1.5 miles.
That's a big shed up there, isn't it?
It is.
In 1,000 feet, continue straight to stay on. Continue straight to stay on North 3100 East, Eastland Drive South. Continue on North 3100 East for 0.5 mile. Take the next right onto US 30 East. Continue on US 30 East for 4 miles.
this has a feel a little bit like orange.
Yeah, or Bathurst. Or Wagga. Or,
yeah.
Shall I get some fuel while we're here?